Hi. Look, you take some water and you put it in a container, even a glass, and you let it sit around for a few weeks by itself without moving, and you'll grow algae. The algae will drop, the algae spores are very light and they get carried by the air, usually, and for most environments, the dust will carry it, and the algae, the green algae, will start growing. They don't need any food. As long as there's light, they can continue to grow, and they're almost inevitable. They're considered by many to be an enemy, but they're actually generate oxygen, and they have a wonderful effect on the environment. But if you do that, and you, I have a tank full of stagnant water. It's been sitting there for quite a long time, and I add leaves and things. And now, on the leaves are also spores and cysts that contain organisms of various kinds and bacteria and so you develop a biome, and I've been looking at this for a long time, and it's fairly stable because I don't have any fresh biological substances coming from the outside. I haven't had it since the beginning of the winter, but I wanted to take an inventory of what lives in the algae kingdom, because what you've got is kind of an environment dictated by the algae. One of the things that there are things that grow along with algae. I mean, that basically are algae. Those are the diatoms that are algae that independently develop and have a little well glass shells around them, and then you have the cyanobacteria, which are not algae, but bacteria, but they sort of co-occur with the with algae. And then you have the our relatives, our kindred, the ciliates that move in a kind of familiar way, and the bacteria and the smaller organisms, like so let's take a look and see what's in this algae kingdom, algae territory. Take a look.